video demonstrates how easy it is to quickly create a production line in which a source produces parts, which two machines process, and which the drain removes from the plant. To get started, start plant simulation and click Create New Model. In the dialog box, which opens, you can select if you want to create the model in 2D or in 3D. We select 3D. On the Ribbon tab, View, click Planning View. Now we see the scene and the grid from the top. This makes it easier for us to place the objects in the correct position. Maximize the window and move the modeling area so that the event controller is located in the upper left corner. First, we insert the objects we need, namely a source, two stations, and a drain. To do so, move the mouse over the source in the toolbox. Select the source, drag the mouse to the location in the frame where we want to place it, and click the left mouse button. This inserts an instance of the source. Select the station, single pros, in the toolbox, and drag the mouse to the location in the frame where you want to place it. Now press the Control key to preserve the selection of the station in the toolbox. This allows you to insert several instances of the station. Finally, select the drain in the toolbox and place it in the frame. Next, we connect the objects so that the parts can move from station to station through the plant. To connect several objects, one after the other, select the connector in the toolbox. Hold down the Control key while clicking on the objects in the frame. To terminate connect mode, click the right mouse button or press the Escape key. Switch off planning view mode. Now we are ready to run the simulation. To do so, click Reset and Start on the Home Ribbon tab, or click the right mouse button to open the context menu. After a few seconds have passed, click the Start-Stop button again to stop the simulation and check its results. Double-click the drain to open its dialog. Click the tab, Type Statistics, to see the most relevant statistic data of the produced parts. On this tab, we see the average lifespan of the products, the total throughput, the throughput per hour, and other important values. Naturally, you want to view statistics of the stations. Double-click a station and change to the tab Statistics. You can also present the results of the simulation graphically with the chart. Select the chart in the toolbox of the Toolbar User Interface. Drag the mouse to the location where we want to place it and click the left mouse button. Drag a marquee over the material flow object whose data you want to show. Drag the selection over the icon of the chart and drop it there. As we want to show resource statistics of the objects, we click OK in the dialog Statistics type. The chart shows that the stations were working all of the time. This is not very realistic though, as machines tend to fail in a real plant. To simulate a more realistic situation, let's use an availability of 90% for all the stations. As both machines are to use the same availability, you can change it in their class. To do so, double-click the station in the toolbox and click the tab Failures. Click New to define a new failure. Plant simulation has predefined values for availability and mean time to repair, or MTTR. Enter 90 for the availability of the station. When you click Apply, plant simulation automatically enters the corresponding interval and duration. Click OK. When you open the dialog of the station, you see that they inherited the settings of their class. Finally, reset the simulation and run it again. When you check statistics of the station, you see that in addition to working, they now also failed, were blocked, and were waiting. In the Resources Statistics chart, we also see the blocking portion and the waiting portion of the station. Open the type statistics of the drain. Here we see that also the throughput per hour decreases from 60 parts per hour to about 45 parts per hour. This concludes our video about creating a simple simulation model.